while others, like myself, may be a little more well done. But what does the perfect steak look like? Well, the Valley Today's Abby Furchner joins us live to give us some tips on how you can get perfection in your steak this summer. Good morning, Abby.
Good morning, Jordan. Yes, I'm here at Cashwise on 13th Avenue with Stu Jurger, and we're going to be talking about all things steak and how to get that perfect steak for your summer barbecue. And we have a New York strip right here.
Yep.
And you kind of told me a little interesting fact. A T-bone, we have a bunch of steaks on the grill that you're going to want to look at. So a T-bone is actually
a New York strip, and then also the tenderloin on the other side.
I did not know that.
Yeah, the tenderloin is the most tender part of the steak in my mind.
Okay, and then what else do we got on the grill here?
We have our top sirloin.
Okay.
Then we have our ribeye, which is close second in for my flavor.
Favorites.
Yeah, it's nice and marbleized, and on this side we have our Omaha 1881 steaks.
Okay.
They're the high-end steaks that we carry, and they're corn-fed.
Okay.
You know, so it brings them the most rich steak flavor that we carry. And then the other ones that we have are the Hereford beef.
Okay, should we throw this one on?
Sure.
Okay, because do they have to all cook differently, or can they all cook at the same temperature?
All the steaks have to be cooked to 145 degrees.
Okay, and when you start your grill up, what temperature should you have them at?
What I like to do, I like to turn it all the way up so that the grates are nice and hot.
Okay.
And the reason for that is for when you flip your steak,
Ooh,
you have the nice sear marks.
Look at that, that's perfect. And you have a little trick. You say not to flip them too many times.
You only want to flip it one time.
Okay, why is that?
And the reason for that is because you see the nice seared part? That
yeah.
seals in the juices.
Okay.
So you want to seal in the nice steak juices.
Wow, and that's a big T-bone.
That's the very nice, very nice cut.
That is ginormous. And so you have a couple different little sauces that you put on here. So does this, in your opinion, is this what makes your steak good, is the seasonings?
The steak is what makes it. And then the seasonings just add more to it.
They just add to it.
You know, on our backyard barbecues, we have a Cashwise secret sauce, we call it, where everybody thinks it's so special, but it's really so easy. A lot of it is soy sauce. And I can't really tell anymore after that. But then we also do have our Four Brothers seasonings.
Okay.
The prime rib seasoning I use on all my steaks.
And one more time, 145, and that's the perfect temperature.
For steaks, yes.
For a steak. So there you have it. Just flip it one time, keep that moisture locked in, get that steak to 145 in the center, and that seems to be the perfect steak for your barbecue. But when it comes to brats and hamburgers, there's a little bit of different technique and a little bit of different temperature you'll want to get it at, and we'll show you those tips and tricks when we come back.
All right, I didn't know that I wanted a steak for breakfast until I saw those. They are looking delicious. Abby Furchner.
That T-bone, that will get you.
Oh, yeah, they look real good. Abby Furchner reporting live. Are you looking to update your home security?